All right, in this episode, I'm going to show you briefly how I restored this vintage PR&E BMX 3 analog on-air console. So stay tuned. This is what it pretty much looks like before I start. It's in pretty good shape, actually. The wood grain's a little, you know, messed up because people like to engrave their name on it and post-it notes here and there, and it's just dirty. Got some oil rubbed into it and some gouges. So I just got back. First step is I gutted this console completely, and you have to get the wood side panels off the front and the side. So I just got done sanding these all down. I got all the nicks and scratches out of it here. The side panel, one side panel was gouged up a little too deep for me to do anything with, so I had to run it through the planer, and it looks like brand new now. Just got done running this through the planer. So the wood is perfect. I'm gonna go out in the shop right now and finish sanding these edges down and put some walnut stainies or walnut side panels. I don't care if they, some people say mahogany, they're not. They're, whoa, that's not good though. Yeah. All right, wood's all ready to install back. So with the console still gutted, we have long screws and short screws. The long screws go on this front piece, the short screws go on the side. Very important. Panels that fit in once you install the console to cover up some of the stuff from behind. So I do have those. Power supply next. Normally you get two power supplies and a changeover box like this, but just for purposes of me testing hooking up, I'm not going to go ahead and put all those on. I'm just going to hook in one power supply because it's heavy enough the way it is. So there's the one power supply, very, very heavy. I'm going to hook this up and get it powered up, get ready to start putting modules in. Pretty much a time-consuming process. Clean, repair, and reinstall. Pretty much will take, if you can stay on it, you can do it in about a day. If you find problems with it, several days. If you have to order parts, even longer. I have to order light bulbs, so I've got to wait till I'm all done, put all them in. That's done. There's your, these are cool switches. Your AM and FM and your take. You flip this up. Bomb detonating. Take these two screws here out to get to the inside the fader and clean inside that and oil it so it glides really smooth. Clean that surface. Since it's Mike, I'm going to stick with the bright colors like yellow, red, or orange. And there it is, ready to reinstall. All right, it's finished up. It looks great. Sounds great. As you can see, I checked each channel before I put it back in. Cleaned all the pots, then the switches. Lubed them up so they activate really good. Right now, I'm running this microphone into the fourth mic channel. There's only four mic channels, and the rest are all line, stereo line. I'm running it into that and feeding it to the direct output. Each module has a direct out, so direct out into the camera. So if there's any noise, it's probably coming from the microphone preamps in the camera. They're not notorious for being good mic preamps, but gives you an idea what the faders sound like. Stuff like that for the mic channel. I'm actually, I can boost it a little more. This is a ribbon mic, so it does have enough preamp. They're turned all the way up for a vintage ribbon microphone. I'm also not hooking up the 48 volt phantom power, which if I did that, it would supply 48 volts to all the microphone inputs. So that's unhooked right now. I guess I could put this on a cloud lifter and use the 48 volt phantom power and turn the mic preamps down, but What's the point of that, right? Lamps and the meters. There's three lamps per meter, and I've got several of these consoles, so if you need spare parts, contact me at www.bigdmc.com. So I'll have some extra parts because I may end up parting one of the consoles out, but they're in fabulous shape to start with, so my job was kind of easy doing this restoration. It comes with this, if you get it before I sell these things, comes with this little copy stand here. I've got the manual on it now. It does come with a full manual, service manual, and operating manual. It's pretty easy to operate. It's all self-explanatory. I put new fader knobs. Sent off to England to get the pinion jowl fader knobs. So I've got them in black, white, red, green, yellow, and orange. So it's got all new knobs. All new meter lights, all new lamps and the start, stop, on, off buttons. And it's pretty much good to go. It's old enough. It says Pacific Recorders and Engineering, where the new ones are Pacific Research and Engineering. So this is the old school analog console ready to ship out today from Big D Broadcast Exchange at www.bigdmc.com. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. It takes a whole lot of liquor to lie.